This is the Orbea Gain D30, and today I am going to do my long-term review on the bike. I've just had it over 2 years, and everything I've learned and know, I'm going to go through it now. So if you are thinking about buying one, I can try and help you before you buy. So let's go. So let's go through the important thing first, the price of the bike. You can get yourself one of these from Sigma Sports at the minute for £2,299. As long as you don't mind having it in the Borealis blue and black colour, which I'll show you over now what it looks like. That is the 2023 version. That's the newest one out of the D collection. Mine is a 2022, but it's exactly the same X35 Plus system. So that's the price. So let's go through the rest of the bike. And firstly, let's talk about the engine, the X35 Motion system. So, what's good about the X35 Motion system? Well, firstly, let's have a look at the bike. I'll put some over stills of the bike. You can see from here that the bike doesn't look nothing like an e-bike. And that's what firstly drawn me to the bike. It just looks like a normal bike. You can't really tell that the motor's on the back of the wheel. And obviously the battery is in the down tube. So you don't see that either. Like most of them big clunky batteries on top of the down tube. They look absolute awful, but this looks a beautiful looking bike. And the X35 system is a really good system. So let's talk about the X35 Motion system. You're getting 40 newton meters of torque of natural, almost drag-free support, powered by a 250 watt battery, which is in the down tube. And as like all other bikes, it looks like a normal bike. You wouldn't distinguish it from any other as a normal bike. The motor in the back hub is hardly recognizable from the side. You have to really look hard to see it. And the system itself, it works like a dream. So what Marley have done to make it a non-intrusive experience on the e-bike, they've basically put the controller on the top tube. They've designed an iWalk 1 remote to be integrated in the top tube. However, the iWalk switch is not just a regular on and off switch, but an intelligent system to control your smart bike. The eWalk 1 allows the rider to toggle between the different support levels, while the colours of the LED ring indicate the support, intensity, battery level, and if the Bluetooth connection is established. To complete the minimalistic look, the cables can be routed through the head tube directly into the frame. So as you can see, all the wiring is internal. So that's another thing what I like. All the wiring, you can't see it. It's all internal in the cockpit and then goes down into the down tube, down to your gear system. And it absolutely looks a beautiful looking bike. And that's one thing what drawed me to the bike. Yeah, so another thing the X35 system does, it can connect up to your cycling computers. This is my Garmin 840, and this is what the screen looks like once it's connected. Like I say, I have done playlists of how to connect this up to the X35 system. It's in the playlist at the end of this video. Take a look if you want to know how to do it. And it's obviously just straightforward. You can change your assist levels here. It gives you the battery and expected range, but that's going off from your last ride. I did a lot of the hills on my last ride, so that will change as you per your riding, and when you're using through the assist levels, it will go up or down depending what your terrain is and what weight you are. But yeah, that's it. The 250 watt battery is basically a Panasonic battery, and it says on the website that you can get up to 500 cycles of charge and you'll still get 90% of the capacity of the battery. I'm on about 62 cycles within 2 years, so it just shows how many cycles you can get before your battery starts deteriorating. And I've done plenty of tests on the battery over the 2 years, and at the end of this video there'll be a playlist of every single video I've ever done on the bike, so please take a look at them. They will help you if you need to know more about the bike. And obviously, if you are finding this video very helpful, or you want to see more on the Orbea Gain, or seeing me doing crazy things, taking this up
crazy climbs and hills up the Lake District. And think about subscribing. It does help my channel. And obviously I've got plenty of videos what you can have a watch if you do love cycling. And there is a lot of videos there what will help you decide if you do want to buy one of these bikes. So like and subscribe. Right, let's get on to the rest of the bike. Basically, what you get is you get an aluminium frame with a carbon fork. The one good thing about this bike is you can get up to 740 width of tyres, and that's the one thing I like. I've took the Hutchinson tyres what come with them, and I've got a pair of G1 Schwalbe on, which are 735s, and I find these absolutely brilliant for where I live, where the roads, there's plenty of potholes, and they're all uneven gravel surface. These tyres are really brilliant, and they work well. The Blackjack tyres are alloy, and they are tubeless ready, and I've got mine tubeless, and I will recommend going tubeless if you can, because it does help a great deal. The charging point is just at the bottom of the down tube. It's easy enough to do. You just plug it in. It takes around about 3 hours from zero to maximum charge. And I've never had any problems with it. And it works really well. Obviously, the system as well has its own app. And you can change the motor system settings. So you can have level 1, level 2, level 3 at different levels of percentage of battery you want to do. And that also helps if you don't want to use as much of the power when you are getting fitter and fitter and you want to use less power. Obviously, I've done plenty of videos how to change the motor maps and that. That's in the playlist at the end. Have a look at them because they will help. So, the D30 comes with a 105 system. It is really good. And if you can afford to go to the 105 system, I highly recommend it. I did have the Claris groups on and I had no book problems with it, so I've replaced it and got the 105 system, and it is absolutely brilliant. I absolutely love it. And it is mechanical and it comes with hydraulic brakes, so that is another game changer. When I went from mechanical to hydraulic brakes, it is absolutely brilliant, and I highly recommend getting hydraulic brakes if you can afford it. Yeah, and the bike does look and it does ride really well. And the one good thing with the rear hub system on the X35 is when you use this bike as a normal bike, when the system is switched off, it does feel like a normal bike. The weight of the bike comes in around about 14.8 kilograms last time I weighed it, depending what size tyres and stuff you've got on and whatever added things you've put on. But that's what this weighs. It's slightly heavy, but as for an e-bike, that is light. I mean, the last e-bike I had, it was like 25 kilograms. So it is a light bike. It's not a super light racing bike. This is not carbon. Don't forget, if you want to go into the Orbea Gain carbon range, they're the M versions. And that's going to be a hell of a lot more lighter than this. I think they're around about 11 to 12 kilograms. But this one, honestly, I have it switched off nearly a lot of the time and you can't feel the weight. It goes up hills really well with the battery off and there's no drag or anything. And it's, you know, a really, really good ride. It's really comfortable. The seat, I've never changed it. It's the one that will come with it. It is a really comfortable seat. I've done 70, 80 miles on this seat and it does exactly what you need it to do. And it works really well. So that's my long-term review. I hope it's helped you. If there's any questions, put it in the comments. Hopefully I haven't missed anything. But if I have, put it in the comments. I'm just going to go out on a ride. So hopefully that'll be my next video after this. And I'm going to put up now some videos of the playlist, what I've mentioned in the video. So anything you need to know about the bike, it'll be in that playlist. How to connect your Garmin, how the battery runs, how long you get out of the battery, stuff like that. Anything you need to know, have a look in that playlist. And then I'll put a video there of when I've been doing some climbs in the Lake District. So thanks for watching. And like I said, subscribe and like the video. And I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.